بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي السلام عليكم This is the lecture for second year week 2 and we are going to start unit 6 about the culture of Pakistan before going into the culture of Pakistan let's see what is culture and how it is going to form According to the anthropologists, culture is the social heredity that transfers from one generation to another generation through individual and cumulative experiences. While it includes all the beliefs, knowledge, ethics, laws, custom, fun, and other habits and qualities of the societies that could help the society to revive. For example, our beliefs that to whom we are going to worship. Like in many of the civilization, including the Mesopotamian civilization, the Greek civilization, and Roman civilization, what was their belief? How many gods do they have? After that, what kind of a knowledge research they have done? Then what kind of a laws they have? For example, in Mesopotamian civilization, the code of Hammurabi was a set of laws to govern the civilization. And the other qualities, including cuisines, dresses, and many other things that can help a society to revive. Now, culture is the common thing, but the common thing is made by the individual experiences. That means, when a specific value or norm is going to be practiced by all of the individual of the society, then it became the common thing. It is practiced individually, but still it is the common that it is practiced by all of the individuals of the societies. Now, how the culture form? The basic intrusion into any of the society are values. Values are basic code of lives that are present in any of the society. And after the values, when they are going to be practiced, they became norm. And norms are the rigid values of the society. When norms are going to practice for a longer time, they will become the culture. Now, what are the types of culture? There are two main types of the culture, materialistic and non-materialistic culture. Materialistic culture consists of things that are the needs of human being, while the non-materialistic culture include values, religion, way of thinking, festival, and knowledge. While apart from these two cultures, we have universal culture based upon the humanity, and it directed us towards the basic ethics of life. Now, Professor Toynbee, who has written the book A Study of History, has done the research that how any of the civilization is going to form and fall. Now, what is civilization? Civilization is any group of people that have specific culture that make them different from any other society. So, if we take the example of Roman civilization and Mesopotamian civilization, we can understand origin of civilization, development of a civilization, and fall of the civilization easily. When we are talking about the origin of civilization, we must know that how the Roman civilization and Mesopotamian civilization has grown. While growing around the rivers, of River Tiber in Roman civilization, it was developed around the River Tiber, while the Mesopotamian civilization was grown in between two rivers, River Tigris and Euphrates. Now, what was the common thing that was being practiced over there? It was their occupation of agriculture. As people were living together in the Mesopotamian civilization, and due to the fertile soil over there and the provision of water, they used to practice agriculture. And this is how the people start living together in the Mesopotamian civilization. Later, they have developed with the passage of time. When the number of the people increase, their laws, mode of living has modified. But at the end, when the civilization starts to leave their culture behind, or many new values and norms are being intruded into the civilization, it can cause the fall of civilization. Now, how Pakistan is the center of ancient civilization? If we see Pakistan, we will come to know about that in ancient times, Indus Valley civilization and Gandhara civilizations were important civilizations present in present Pakistan. Apart from that, Pakistan has also remained under the Mughal Empire. So many of the historical places could be found in Pakistan. When we are talking about Indus Valley civilization, it is nowadays Punjabi culture is dominated by the culture that was followed in the Indus Valley. And the main centers of Indus Valley civilization were Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. While if we talk about the Gandhara civilization, it was predominantly a Buddhist civilization. And Buddhism was basically the diversion of Hinduism. So, Gandhara civilization is still dominating in Pakistan. Its main center were Pushklavati, that is present Charsadda, Kanishkapura, Peshawar, while Taxila was served as the educational centers, where many of the idols were found in the stupas that were the worship place for them. Many of the historical places are also found in Pakistan, including Shahi Qila, Masjid Mahabad Khan, Jamia Masjid, Thatta. As this is the revision lecture, we are going to go steadily.